Hi everybody, it's Dr. Vanessa, the people's nephrologist. This time I want to talk about high blood pressure and the kidneys. Now, this is in the context of Ms. Tina Turner's recent passing on May 24th and how she talked about it. One quote that has been publicized a lot is, if I had known how high blood pressure and kidney disease are connected, I would have been spared a lot of suffering. Now, as a nephrologist, that statement really saddened me because it just tells me that we have a lot of work to do in terms of the healthcare community in educating people about what their risks for disease are. But one quote from her that I particularly want to highlight is this one. So 2 months before her death, she said, "My kidneys are victims of my not realizing that my high blood pressure should have been treated with conventional medicine." Now, this is particularly important, I think, to talk about because I know most people want nothing to do with doctors. Most people don't want to take any pills. I get it. However, I really encourage you not to let too much time go by with just trying herbal remedies or supplements because, one, some of them can actually be dangerous for the kidney, so let us know if you're taking anything. And two, there's no reason why you can't do things concurrently. The longer you let blood pressure higher than 130 over 80 go, stay like that, the more at risk you are of causing irreversible damage to your kidneys, okay? So I'm not a big fan of herbal remedies in general. I tend to think they're a waste of money, but if people want to try them and I can't find that they're causing any harm, go for it. Do you, right? But other things that you can do that we know are effective for helping to control blood pressure are big ones are salt. And it's not just how much you're shaking on your food, it's all the prepared stuff, preservatives. You think about a cookie recipe that has salt in it. Salt makes things taste good, but my advice is just to try to eat as fresh as possible. And I know fresh fruits and veggies can get really expensive, but keep in mind, frozen counts. Okay, frozen counts as good as fresh and usually a fraction of the cost. Another big thing is our weight. If we are overweight, that's going to directly affect our blood pressure. And it's not like you have to be any kind of skinny mini. Just a 5% body weight loss can make a nice dent. Other things that you can do are getting more active. And it's not like you have to, run a marathon or anything. Just a nice walk, 20, 30 minutes a day can do wonders for controlling your blood pressure and your stress. We know that's that one is involved as well. And then getting good sleep. One side note, if you are under 30 or you're already on and taking four medications and your blood pressure is still not under good control, this may be a reason for your provider to look for a secondary cause of your high blood pressure, like something else going on in the body that can be treated that will take care of your blood pressure as well. Most of the things are pretty rare, but you should definitely get checked out. But some of the more common things that can cause high blood pressure are drug use, particularly methamphetamine and cocaine. And even though it's legal, there's no good that comes from any number of cigarettes. It can affect your blood pressure too. So these are all the things you can do to prevent or control blood pressure even without medications, but most people will need a medication and probably two. Every adult, get your blood pressure checked at least every year along with just a general exam, and get blood and urine tests to detect for even early kidney damage. If you already have high blood pressure, you definitely need to be checked more often. Time is kidney. You got to get it under control. And for the folks who feel like they have white coat high blood pressure, like your blood pressure is only high when you go to the doctor, that actually increases your risk for developing just straight high blood pressure along the way. So don't just ignore that. I would get that checked every few months. And I would also encourage you to ask about ambulatory blood pressure monitoring. That's where you can go home with a gadget that'll check your blood pressure throughout the day and night, so we can really see if it is just at the doctor. Now, finally, I want to give a shout out to another organization that I just learned about that provides lots of bites of health information. This is Grapevine Health. And they're primarily on Instagram, Facebook, and here on YouTube. So with that, I'll leave it. I'll be back soon. And I hope this was helpful. Please like, if you like, subscribe, and share with somebody else who might benefit from this information. Okay? Y'all take good care.